The very first time I heard about ChatGPT, I was really motivated to start and use it in my daily work. So I started directly by asking questions about SCP-ERP, like technical questions. And back then, all the answers I got from ChatGPT about technical questions were actually wrong. So I started by giving questions about things that I already know, so this way I can confirm whether ChatGPT can give the correct answers, and I can confirm whether I can actually depend on it on my daily work. But then because the answers were wrong, I told myself that maybe ChatGPT is not able to handle technical topics and technical issues, but is more for general uses, such as writing emails or improving articles and so on. So I started using it only for emails and articles and other general uses. And since then, I have learned a lot about ChatGPT. And I have learned that the issue was not in ChatGPT itself, but was in the way that I instruct ChatGPT to give me the answers. And today I'm able to ask the questions and to instruct ChatGPT in the right way to get correct answers about technical topics in SCP and other things. So I can use ChatGPT to learn about new technical topics. I can also use it to handle different technical errors and so on. In the video today, I will tell you about the different cases when I use ChatGPT every day at work. And I will also explain to you how to instruct ChatGPT in the right way to get the best results.
Internal accounting entries in every step. The SAP reports. Business process so integration is for HANA.
My first use case for ChatGPT is to write down notes. So if there is anything I would like to note down, for example, any ideas or thoughts or any conversations I want to remember, any activities to do, then I use the ChatGPT application on my iPhone to note these down. You can also use it on Android. It can work the same way. So the way I do this is I start a new conversation with ChatGPT, and in this conversation, I give instructions that here I'm going to give all my notes. So in the future, I'm going to ask you to retrieve these notes for me. I tell ChatGPT this exactly. And then I start noting down anything I want. And the way I discuss with ChatGPT always is by using the voice feature. I do not type anything because it takes time. The way you can use the voice feature is very simple. So on the iPhone application or Android application, you go to the ChatGPT app here, and then you click on this microphone icon. Once you click on this microphone icon, ChatGPT is going to start recording whatever you say. So you see here, it started recording everything that I'm saying now. So I'm talking and it's recording, and it will convert everything I say into text. Once you are done, you click on this check mark. So here, and then it will convert this voice message into text. And it is able to understand, it has the ability to understand any language and any dialect. It is really amazing. So I can talk in Egyptian Arabic, I can talk in very bad English. It would understand what I'm saying, and it is going to take notes. And then you send this message to ChatGPT. And in the future, if you would like to ask any questions about your notes, you can say, retrieve the note that I gave you at this day, at this time, and it would do. You can also ask to give you a summary of all the notes that you have given. It is really useful. So just start a new conversation and tell ChatGPT about the purpose of this conversation, and then start noting down anything you want. My second use case of ChatGPT is to respond to emails and LinkedIn messages. And this really helped me a lot and saved me a lot of time. And it even made me look better in front of the others. Because when ChatGPT writes an email, when you give the correct instructions, the email can be very professional. So 2 months ago, I added the open to work sign on my LinkedIn profile. And because of this, I started receiving a lot of emails and a lot of LinkedIn messages. And I was able to respond to all of them in a very professional way, thanks to ChatGPT. So the way I did this is I started a new conversation on ChatGPT, and then I shared my CV, my LinkedIn profile, my YouTube page with ChatGPT. So I started by saying, my name is Abdullah Galal, and here is my LinkedIn page, here is my YouTube, here is my CV. I want you to go and learn about me, and then give me a summary of everything that I know. So this way I can confirm that it actually found the correct results and it was able to check the documents and the channel and so on. So it came back to me saying Abdullah Galal is an SCP consultant and so on with a lot of details. And then I was sure that the ChatGPT knows who I am. And then I started using only this conversation to respond to all different emails and messages that are related to recruitment. Remember that on ChatGPT, usually whatever you say in a conversation is only saved to this conversation. So if you give a lot of information about yourself, who you are, your CV, and so on, in one conversation with ChatGPT, this information is only private to this conversation. So if you start a new conversation after this and ask ChatGPT, do you know who I am? It wouldn't be able to answer. There are some memories that are saved, but most of the time you'll find a lot of missing details. So my advice is, whenever you start a conversation with ChatGPT, is to share all the information that is needed on this conversation so ChatGPT can give you the correct results. Now, if you ask ChatGPT to respond to recruitment emails and messages without introducing yourself, it will give you a very bad result. And this is why some people use ChatGPT and other people say that it's useless. So start by introducing yourself, sharing all the information that you have that are related to your professional life, so your CV, your LinkedIn profile, anything else that you have. And then after this, whenever I receive an email or a message that is for recruitment from LinkedIn, then I would copy this email or message, paste it on the conversation, and ask ChatGPT to respond. As simple as that. I do not write any responses. So even if the email is very long, like, dear Mr. Recruiter, thank you for sending me the email and so on, I do not write anything. I just go to ChatGPT, I copy the message, paste it on ChatGPT, and then I give some instructions. So for example, tell the recruiter that I'm not interested, or tell the recruiter that I'm interested, but I want to know more details about the package and so on. So I write only one or two lines and then send. And I also added one instruction to ChatGPT to respond in the same way or in the same style of the message. So for example, if someone sends to me an email saying, dear Mr. Galal, then the response should be, dear Mr. Recruiter. But if someone is sending an email saying, hi Galal or hi Abdullah, then the response would be, hi Recruiter. So the same style that is used in the message is used in the response, and this is very professional. This use case is very useful to me, especially because I live in a foreign country. So I live in France, and my written French is not perfect. I can write English very well, but I'm still new to French. So whenever I want to respond to a recruiter who sends to me in French in an email or a LinkedIn message, I always use ChatGPT. So this way I know that the response is very professional, correct. I don't have to check the grammar or vocabulary or anything. Just be sure that you mention to ChatGPT to respond in the same style of the message. Because in a language like French, for example, we have different forms for respect. So you can use to for someone that you want to speak as a friend, and use vous for someone that you want to speak to as with respect, so in a professional manner. Sometimes when you receive messages and emails, some people use the informal word. Other times people use the formal word. So I always respond in the same style of the message received. And this is how I'm able to respond to hundreds of emails and messages without wasting a lot of time and without having to check my grammar and my style and my vocabulary every time. My third use case for ChatGPT is learning on the go. So this is something I started doing around a month ago, and it is really amazing. You can chat with ChatGPT in voice. So you can start a voice chat with the ChatGPT application on your iPhone or Android, and ChatGPT is going to respond to you also in voice. So you can start a conversation as if you are talking to a friend on Messenger or on any chat application. So you can start this feature while walking, biking, or sitting in a cafe or wherever you are, and start discussing with ChatGPT about any topic you want. So the way you do this is you go to the application and you click on this white icon here. So once you click up, ChatGPT is going to show this circle, which means that it's starting to listen. And here now it's listening to whatever I say. So this is a chat. Once I stop speaking, it will respond to me.
Salut, comment puis-je t'aider aujourd'hui?
Here you go. And it's speaking French. So this is how we can start chatting with ChatGPT. You can ask about any topics you want, and it will give you the answers, and then you continue the chat and so on. The good thing is about this is once you end this chat, you will get a summary of all the conversation. This is not actually a summary. It is a detailed, like, word by word text of whatever you said and any response that you got, which is very useful because then you can ask ChatGPT to summarize this, create a presentation, help you with anything. So it is really useful and you need to start using it. My fourth use case for ChatGPT is to learn technical topics in SAP ERP and to handle technical system errors. Now I understand very well how to do this. When I first started using ChatGPT, I had no idea. This is why I got wrong answers. But now I understand how to instruct ChatGPT in the right way. So you need to be very careful when asking technical questions to ChatGPT. The way to do this is to create a new conversation again and to introduce yourself that you are an SAP consultant, your name is this, give your LinkedIn profile, your CV, any information that you can share about who you are is useful. And then ask ChatGPT to be your advisor in learning topics about SAP and in handling different technical errors. After this, whenever you want to learn about a specific topic, do not ask ChatGPT about the topic. So for example, if you go now to ChatGPT, you can try this with me and ask about Grow with SAP, which is a technical name for a product in SAP. So you ask about Grow with SAP and ChatGPT is going to give you a completely wrong answer. The right way to do it is to ask ChatGPT to search for Grow with SAP on the internet. So give this instruction, look for Grow with SAP on the internet and give me a summary of everything that you find with references. So then it would go look on the internet and come back to you with different references that talked about Grow with SAP. Then you can ask the ChatGPT to summarize what is Grow with SAP and explain different details. And here you'll get the right answer. So do not ask direct questions to ChatGPT, but instead you ask ChatGPT to look online for answers. And you need to be very specific. So you have to say, go look online for what is Grow with SAP and give me a summary of what you find. So this way, ChatGPT is going to look for trusted sources online, so SAP blogs, SAP questions, PDFs, and so on, and will come back to you with the correct response. The other way to do it is to share any documents you have about the topic. So for example, if you want to learn about banking in SAP or something like this, and you have some presentations, some PDFs, some videos, some documents, you can share everything with ChatGPT. For videos, you need to find the transcript of the video. So for YouTube videos, there are tools that extract the transcript. For other videos, you need to find a way to get the transcript of the video. You give it to ChatGPT and it will understand everything about the topic and give you a summary and explain what this is. You can also instruct ChatGPT to not add any information from its side. So to only use the information that's available in the documentation and in the videos to get an accurate answer. The same goes for technical errors. So if there is a technical error and you try to ask ChatGPT directly how to handle this error, most of the time you will get a wrong answer. So you get some instructions that have nothing to do with SAP. You'll get some menu paths, some transactions that don't actually work. So the way to do this is to ask ChatGPT to look for this error online and to give you the references and resources that it used to find the answer with a summary of each reference. So for example, it would go and look on the support.sap.com, the SAP support website, the SAP community website, SAP blogs, and so on, and come back to you saying, this is what I found in this site. So in SAP blogs, we found this, in SAP notes, we found this, and so on. And then you can ask for more details about any of them. But if you go directly and ask ChatGPT about an error, most of the time you will get a wrong answer. The same goes for configuration. So if you go to ChatGPT and ask how to configure a specific thing on SAP, most of the time you will get a wrong answer or an answer that's not complete. I have tried it a lot and it doesn't really work. So the way to do this is to look for resources online. So ask ChatGPT again to look for resources online and to come back to you with the answers. You can also find some YouTube videos that talk about the topic. You don't have to listen to all the videos, just you find 5 or 6 videos that look like they are related to the topic. So you get the transcripts, you share all of them with ChatGPT in a minute, and you get a summary. I keep repeating that you have to look online because this is really important. If you ask direct questions, you get wrong answers. You need to be careful about this. I can keep going for another 2 hours about different other use cases for ChatGPT. So for example, you don't have to remember any Excel formulas anymore. You don't have to remember how to code anymore. Everything can be done with ChatGPT if it is related to Excel sheets, Word documents, articles that you need to summarize or you need to write. It's very useful for improving the way you write things. So if you write an article and you want to make it shorter, you want to make it longer. If you'd like to create a presentation, it does not create presentations, by the way. This is a very bad idea. But if you want to generate a presentation, you can ask ChatGPT to give you the text and even the ideas for the different diagrams and the flowcharts that you have in the presentation and so on. So there are many other different use cases that I use every day, but I'm not going to be able to include all of this in one video. So let me know in the comments if you would like me to create another video like this one, telling you about the other use cases of ChatGPT and other AI tools that I started using recently. Also, let me know in the comments How do you use ChatGPT? I'm really interested to know this because I found that every person uses ChatGPT in a different way, because every person can instruct ChatGPT in a different way. So it can be really used for a lot of things, and I'm really eager to explore all the different use cases. So let me know in the comments how you use ChatGPT, and let me know if you want me to create another video like this one talking about other use cases. Don't forget to share this video with your connections and with your friends who refuse to use ChatGPT until today. I still have some friends of my own who refuse to use ChatGPT, and I think it is just a lot of wasted potential. So you can use it to improve your performance and save a lot of time that you can spend on other interesting things. So you can watch a movie or spend the time with your family or do some sport or something. So don't forget to share this video with your friends and connections. Leave me your comments. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you again soon.